Welcome to this video about our managed Gigabit Ethernet switches. This time, we will show you how to apply a new configuration file to the switch. A configuration file contains all settings that can be adjusted in the managed switch. It is usually created using the switch's web interface. We'll show you two methods to do this. First, via USB, and then using the web interface. Using USB has the advantage that we won't need to care about network settings. We need a normal USB flash drive and an adapter cable for the M12 connector. To prepare the flash drive, we plug it into a computer. First, we check that it is formatted with a FAT file system. Then we create a text file called command.txt. Open it up, enter the command apply config file, and save. Finally, we need to copy the actual configuration file to the USB drive. Take care to rename it like shown. This switch is currently in default configuration, just like when it left our factory. When the configuration's name is default, the CFG LED is off, indicating it has not been configured yet. Since the USB flash drive is prepared, we can perform the update. Plug it into the switch using the adapter cable. Now it's important to watch the LEDs on the left. While the mode LED is blinking, the switch is busy applying the configuration file. When the LED is on continuously, the configuration is applied and saved to the switch's memory. We can pull out the USB flash drive. Since the configuration has a new name, the CFG LED is now on. This LED shows whether the switch is in default configuration or not. By the way, resetting the configuration back to default settings works similarly. In that case, the command in the text file must be reset to default config. No configuration file is necessary. After running the command, the CFG LED will be off. Another way to apply the configuration file is using the web interface. For this, we need a working Ethernet connection to the web interface, so the computer's network settings must be configured appropriately. After logging into the web interface, we can navigate to Maintain, Configuration. Just drag and drop, or choose the configuration file here, and click the Apply button. Depending on which settings were contained in the file, we may lose the connection to the web interface. This may be the case for a changed IP address or VLAN settings. So, the next step is connecting to the switch using the new configuration settings. That might mean having to change your computer's network settings to match. After logging in with the correct username and password, we can see the new configuration's name. The settings are now applied, but they are not persistent yet. To preserve them across a power cycle, we must save them to the switch's internal memory by clicking this button. If you would like to return to the switch's default settings, you can do so back in the configuration section. The process is the same. They need to be saved to make them persistent.